has been special, you know, dreaming things like this, you know, coming out of high school and not really sure I was going to make it to this point when I was little, but, you know, I've just been taking it in, you know. First game in the Valley was great, you know, playing against Charleston Southern, big home win, so it's just been special. Yeah, Hamp Green, man, he just worked so hard, and he finally got his opportunity to go and show what he's been working on, you know, every day. Fall camp, summer workouts, just going out there and working, one of the hardest working players on the team. And so, you know, y'all just got a chance to see, you know, how good we are at that position, you know, with Hamp being out there at the end of the game and making a crazy play like that. So, yeah. Well, I was recruited by, you know, other schools, including Alabama and in-state school, but, you know, it wasn't really the things that weren't good about Alabama that drew me to Clemson. It was just that there were so many great things about Clemson that, you know, I just can't say no to. The people, the culture, you know, the ability to be coached by Coach Easton, one of the greatest to ever do it, playing and coaching. So, you know, just those things, amongst other things, are just crazy to just not go for, you know. Yeah, me and TJ, you know, we had a long lasting relationship prior to Clemson, you know, because we played against each other in high school. You know, Alabama 7A football is very competitive, and we were one of the, you know, two best players in our state. So just knowing his game, you know, game recognized his game, and, you know, just the person that he was, I just knew he was a fit for the program. So as soon as, even when he was committed to Penn State, you know, that was still my guy. I was just kind of in his ear like, hey, man, like, we could really do this. We could really run it up here. So it just happened. Yeah, no, TJ, that's like my best friend. Like, we pull up here every day together, and we leave here every day together. And that's just how we've been since we got here. So just that chemistry, I guess you could call it, kind of shows up on the field too. You know, when we're playing together, we communicate really well. And so that's big for us.
Beth Poole from Fox Carolina in Greenville. You mentioned getting to play for Coach Easton. What is it about him and how he connects with you guys?
Yeah, Coach Easton, he's just an all-around good guy. He knows what he's talking about. I mean, he's done it at every level, coached at every level. So, I mean, the credibility is there. And just the fact, you know, that Coach Easton, he cares so much more about his players than just, you know, how they're doing on the field and what they're doing, you know, production-wise. He wants to see you become a great man, ultimately, and just, you know, take up everything that he got to take up when he was here at Clemson and just kind of soak all that in.
How does he show you that he cares about you more than just what you're producing out there on the football field?
Yeah, like, every day, you know, he gives us a food for thought, you know, when we're in our meetings, and he just tries to make sure that we're okay mentally. And so some of our food for thought has just been things that just have nothing to do with football, or just, you know, at-home life, stuff that, you know, that builds the man. And that's kind of what, you know, this program prides itself on.
He talks about leading with his vulnerability. Is that something, is that a word that comes up in your guys' room? And what's even that idea of vulnerability and being able to show vulnerability, how has he shown that to you guys?
Yeah, he's, you know, Coach Easton, everybody knows that Coach Easton's been on a journey, you know, and the fact that he's been willing to share his journey with us to encourage us has made us closer as a room. And I feel like the fact that he's able, you know, to have those talks with us and, you know, to sit us down and just explain us, like, look, guys, like, this is what I'm going through. I know y'all are going through stuff, but you got to do this. You got to fight. And so that's something that, you know, we've learned as a room together, just coming together closely, is just, you know, fighting through. Like, you're always going to have, you know, circumstances that you come against and stuff, obstacles or if you want to call it obstacles, but, you know, just fighting through is just a big thing.
Is that at all what you expected when you were getting ready to come here when you were a senior in high school?
Yeah, I really did. I tell everybody this all the time. What I got during recruiting, which I love, what I got during recruiting whenever I was at Clemson is something that I saw when I got here, and it was just consistent from everybody, Coach Sweeney, Coach Easton, Coach West, you know, just everyone. So.
Do you guys ever tiger around? insist that, that they find you a Big Brother program to be a part of, and that they need to try to get you the false agreement. Why is that so important to you?
Just the importance of just, you know, giving back to the community. That's really, you know, stuff that I did, you know, even when I was back home, just wanting to just give back and make sure that other people have, you know, the things that they need. And if they don't, then if I have something that I can give, then I give them. You know, I think that kind of means to get into this culture and things that I've learned since I've been here, because, you know, we always talk about making sacrifices here. And that's one thing that, you know, I'm willing to do. Yeah, well, they talk about, you know, being a servant leader. It's something that Coach Sweeney talks about all the time. So really just whatever they want me to do for them, you know, if it fits my schedule, I'm going to do it, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm able to, and that's something that's good.
Is it like to talk to, you know, like a young boy that maybe doesn't have the best home life and sees this big football player? What's it kind of like to be a role model for these kids?
You know, it's not easy, but I know that I got here because of the hard work that I put in, you know. So regardless of your circumstance, something that I just always keep harping on, just regardless of your circumstance, it's just that fight that you have in you that's, you know, just gonna keep you going. And one thing that I always preach to these guys is, like, you know, the stuff that I'm living right now was a dream for me. So if you dream and you make it happen, you put in the work, it's gonna happen. So that's one thing that I preach to them.
What do you learn from them?
I learned a lot of things from them, you know, just different things about their the at-home life that maybe I didn't even experience, stuff like that. So.
Coming from Alabaster and Thompson High School, we run across that a lot. Coming to recruiting, like, we've got a ton of players. What's it like at that high school? What makes that high school program so special, and how big is that as part of the town life growing up there?
Yeah, so I don't mean to be repetitive, but a lot of the things that drew me here is because of where I came from. And so a lot of the things that Coach Sweeney instills in us, you know, as far as, you know, a faith-based program, accountability, stuff like that, is stuff that we had in my high school. And so that's a big thing amongst other things that are the reason that I chose to come to this institution, is just because of, you know, the accountability, you know, how the program is built, stuff like that. So that's
in the state of Alabama, 7-8 program, I think, right?
Yes, sir.
How is it state, you know, we think of, like, Dutch Fort,
mm-hmm. Somerville,
Gaffney,
Starkburg, Memphis,
Lake Orange.
What
kind of, what's the reputation of Thompson High football in Alabama?
Yeah, well, to answer your question, you know, in simplest forms, I've been to 5 state championships, and I won 4 of them. So, that's about it.
No,
yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, you're saying. I felt like I was prepared coming out of high school because of the high school that I came from. And just, you know, like I said, a lot of the things that I see in this college institution are things that I had in high school. So I was fortunate enough, you know, to have a great D-line coach coming out of high school, a great head coach coming out of high school that just really prepared me for this next level. And so when I got to the next level, it was just like, you know, just pick up these pieces, transfer this over here, and just keep learning from Coach Sweeney and Coach Easton and Coach Goodwin and different people who just have their hands on my position. Yeah, easily Tyler Davis, Luke Arroyo. They're like, you know, my big brothers. And one thing that I can say about them is, you know, they're very selfless. You know, they're not too scared to, you know, allow me to, you know, come into my own and teach me some of the things that they know, just to, so they can see me be the best version of myself. And they've been big brothers to me, just being able to just, like, stay behind them and just kind of follow their lead and their leadership and just learn things from them, because they've been here for so long and they've seen everything I'm about to come into. It's just special, and it says a lot about their character.
Chase Justice with the WIFF News 4 in Greenville. You mentioned being excited for your first game in Death Valley last week. What are your expectations for the first night game coming up this week in Death Valley?
It's going to be special. I've actually been to a few night games in Death Valley where I've just been sitting up in my seat just hoping and wishing and praying that I get a chance to be out there. So, I mean, it's time now. So, you know, I got to put in the work Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday so it can show up Saturday.
Hey, Peter. Amanda Poole with Watch Fox out of Columbia. You play your first game for Clemson in what Dabo Sweeney called the weirdest game he's ever What did you learn about this team and that Duke loss from the Charleston Southern blowout?
Basically, you know, that we can respond, you know, some of the mistakes that we made in the Duke game, you know, we're not really going to run from them, but we capitalized on them, and we made them not mistakes anymore in the Charleston Southern game. So that's really just, you know, what Coach Sweeney wanted to see from us, just not make the same mistakes in the next game, and you can see that in the coming weeks that we're going to prepare and make sure that we don't make the same little things happen. You know, they're big. You know what I'm saying? They're big. And I like playing big offensive linemen personally because, you know, I'm not the tallest guy. But, you know, we're going to watch them on film and see what they have skill-wise. But being big is part of the game. So, you know, that doesn't really scare us, but we're gonna take it.
Let's go back to being prepared early.
I think we're going to be good. I was probably 5'11". Maybe not even 200 pounds, maybe.
Coach Freeman told me that they don't really play a lot of freshmen and sophomores. You were in eighth grade.
Yeah, yes, sir.
They bring you up to varsity practice, and you drill an old running back, like put him on his back, big violent collision, put the entire world on notice. Do you remember that?
I do remember that. It was. I don't think he told y'all this, but it was during a walkthrough. And we weren't supposed to be really hitting anybody. And, you know, this is one of my first practices coming up, and I didn't really know anything. You know what I'm saying? I was young, immature. I might have been 13 at the time, and so I hit him, and I actually ran through a pulling guard to hit the running back. And he was a little bit down the field, and he ripped me. But he saw something in me, I guess, that, you know, I didn't really see myself at the time, and I just kept building on it. Yeah, it was special, you know, but I just remained humble through it all, and just even like I do in this program, you know, there were older guys there that taught me a lot of things, you know, on the other side of the ball as well. You know, I got to play with Talia Tagovailoa my eighth grade year, and just the wisdom that he had just as a quarterback and just knowledgeable of the game just kind of helped me move along in my game too. I told my dad this the other day, I bench more than I weigh. And so whenever I'm trying to tackle somebody and I hold them up, I'm going to make sure that I put that bench on them and not really just fall on them. And that's just my philosophy. So if I got you held up, I'm going to throw you. That's what I do. I think the last thing I did bench was 475. But when I got here, shout out to D Love and Coach Bassett. When I got here, or when I was leaving high school, I couldn't even bench 405. Like, I was probably in the high 300s, maybe 385 range. And so the last time we maxed out, it was 475. Came from my family. My whole family sings. My mom, she can hold a tune. My dad, brother, sister, and my little sister starting to sing. She's just 12, so she's coming into it. And so that's just a way that we kind of bonded coming up, and so it was fun.
Was it more church?
Yeah, it was. It was church motivated. My dad is actually a pastor about 30 minutes south of Tuscaloosa, so we grew up, you know, singing in church. Not really anything that we were forced to do, but something, like I said, that just, you know, helped our family bond and something that we came together with. Yeah, I was, yes, sir.
What
kind of
music do you sing
now? I sing just about anything. Like, my music taste, I tell those people all the time, my music taste is very versatile. R&B, church music, just anything, really. If I hear it and I can catch a tune, I can tell people to sing it, so. Yeah, I could just kind of credit that to just self-aspiration. I know that there's always things that I can work on to get better, and I'm never going to be the best version of myself, but I'm always going to strive to be the best version of myself, which is going to cause me to, you know, get somewhere close along the way and just keep getting better. So.
What do you think you'll be better at? Like, what do you see out of this whole thing?
I'm always just, you know, stressing myself to get better at the mental aspect of the game, you know, just knowing the guys' jobs around me and just how my job fits into the defense, you know, the grand scheme of things. So that's something that I've really been working on most recently. And just the little things, just perfecting the little things like footwork and stuff like that that people don't really think about.
Are you a TJ roommate?
Yeah. TJ's biggest strength. This sounds like kind of crazy. His biggest strength is his consistency. Dude is pretty much good at everything, and he's consistent at doing it. And so I think consistency is his biggest strength, just being able to just do it over and over and over again. We harp on the fact that, you know, we're doing pass rush in practice, and he does the same move and doesn't lose. And so just somebody who's so consistent at just what they do is, you know, that's going to take him really far. Win. That's what he does. My arm length has really never been a problem for me, and then I got to the next level and realized that it wasn't really a problem for me, so, you know, that's an opinionated. I don't really know how that, you know, transfers onto the field, but I mean, that's somebody else's opinion. I just keep doing what I do. Really just wow, you know, being compared to some Clemson greats right there, and, you know, it's big shoes to fill, but, you know, I'm really just working every day, just going a day at a time and just trying to get, you know, better at the little things every day, and hopefully I can just get half as good as them. Really, I soaked up a lot from them this summer, you know, being here this summer with them, got to get in the film room a little bit and just, you know, just understand the game from their point of view and even at the next level, so it was big just having that time with them this summer and staying around. To be honest, like, after I committed, you know, that was a solid decision. You know, I was a man of my word. I know there was a lot going on about, you know, me possibly committing just to, you know, for sure or flipping, but I made the decision to come to Clemson, and that's just really what it was. So anybody who kind of, like, hit me up after that, you know, I didn't really give them a second thought, not anything against the institution, but just, like I said, because of all the great things that Clemson offered, and I just wasn't going to pass that up.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.